today we're going to the football, the Scotland Royal Football League, but it's the Jazza and the Community Cup. Jazza and the Community is the project that me and my dad run. Families of recovering from addiction and trying to get their lives back on track with the family member. That's what we do. Me and my dad, we're running a programme. That's how we linked up with Weapons Down, to see if we could send any of our kids as an aftercare programme onto them. That's how I got to know David and the gang. But he's named it Jazz in the Community Cup, which is such an honour, because me and my uncle, like, we was in this league when I was a kid. He was the manager, I played for him. You could never make it up, you know. So I'm going to go there today. And to make it even more special, it's my cousin's team who's in the final. So, yeah, our auntie and his little fella Ben, they're in the final. So, yeah, I'm going to try and be biased, but I'm handing out the cup, which is an honour. And if it all goes as planned, I'll be handing the cup to our little Ben. Who knows, you know? So, should be a special day. My family's going to come, we're going to pick my ma up now. So you're going to have to get in the back, because that's my ma's seat. So, that's where we're off.
Alright.
It's really nice, isn't it? The little
fella
wins it.
Yeah.
He said he hasn't lost in 18 months.
Oh, really?
I don't know what's going to be coming. Joseph said he might come, and Thomas said he might bring Isabel.
I've seen how big she's gone, James. Isabel.
She's not going
big.
It's only you to be there.
Is it?
He might have been doing YouTube for years. Haven't you subscribed to the channel? That's all I knew. We're looking for the pitch, we're a bit lost, but take a steady arm, me ma.
Training, didn't even tell us, do you remember that?
Yeah. Got the car, ran over.
Got ran over and still got up and went to boxing.
I said to me, cousin, don't tell the coaches, you'll send me home. And when we got in the gym, he said, he's just been ran over, because he knew that he'd send us both home, and he'd have to chaperone me. Human.
We'll be right back. ladies and gents. Today's Cup One final is the Jazza in the Community Cup final. Jazza Dickens, James Dickens. The reason we put this trophy in honour of James, sorry, it's James to me, is because of what James and his family and friends have done within the community, and it's bringing kids and the families together that may have had a bit of an issue, whatever the case may be, but bringing them together, and they're doing an absolute amazing job, and the community can't thank them enough. Also, James played in the Scotland Road League, and his dad managed in the Scotland Road League, so he means him and what he's doing today, even in his boxing, means an awful lot to the Scotland Road League. He has won professional fights. World title fight, yeah, boys. I've got to say though, I think football was his first love. Would it be right, James? So he was a fantastic footballer and still plays, and he's a professional world title boxer as well. So let's have a massive round of applause. Woo! And we also have a round of applause for your spectators and your parents and your managers.
What's that, Jazz?
Jazz in the community, look, Scotland Road Cup. Scotland Road JFL, the best league in the world.
Good
little day, our lads won. I was trying to be impartial, but when did your cousin's team? You can't be, can you? But we won 6-2. Ben scored one as well, my little cousin Ben. Great little player. And yeah, it was nice to see them lift the cup. And then it was a pleasure to go there and back to my own football league, where I used to play Sunday League with the Byron. And yeah, presented Sophie. It was nice.
Where are we going, Jazza?
We're going pigeon grabbing. In the 90s, this is what kids had to do to entertain themselves. He got loaves of bread or corn, and he went and caught pigeons. Any of them was good, they had a ring on it. You keep them in a loft, feed them for about two weeks, 3 weeks, and you feed them every day. You make them hungry, you let them out, and then you shake your corn and throw it back in the loft. If they come back in the loft, back for the food, they're your birds, because they're trained out.
Are you winding me up?
No. And then you let them out, you never let them out in the full belly. Next day you let them out hungry again, and then you throw your corn back in the loft, and they get them back in the loft. They keep doing that. The old birds. People race them, racing pigeons. They're worth a few quid, aren't they?
Right.
People go on to race them and enter them into races, you get prize money and stuff like that. But I never went as far as that. But we go pigeon grabbing. We keep the pigeons, put the ones that we like.
And you've got two loaves of bread?
Yep.
Why is it called robber bread?
It's called Robert's bread.
It looks like robber bread to me.
Yeah, the stereotypical Scouse shouts with your van since I was like 12. They just wear off in the end. They don't just bounce off me. I don't even see it personally.
Why have you got one thick loaf and one thin loaf just in case they fancy a different?
Some birds like it.
Shut up.
Some birds like a tin with butter on. But you'll see this now.
So you're going to run around and catch pigeons?
I'm going to run around. I'm going to stealthily creep up on these pigeons. I'm not going to keep them and I'm not going to harm them. So if anyone watching, I'm going to just put my love back under me. If anyone watching thinks that I'm harming the birds, that's not the case. I wouldn't do that. Unless they had a ring on the foot. And if you can get a ring off the leg without cutting the leg off, I'll be surprised. Very surprised. Because when the babies, you put the ring on the leg and then the leg grows and then you can't get the ring off the foot, so it's got the ring on the foot all its life. But people like me, when I'm a kid, we collect rings, so you'd swap the rings. This is what kids where I'm from would do. So yeah, if it's got a ring on, we'll snap its leg off. You ever see a pigeon walk around with one leg?
Hang on, you just started that, we're not going to harm any birds, but you're going to end it with snapping their legs off.
Allegedly. People do that, allegedly. No, I wouldn't do that.
ET's just gone past.
Oh no. So, we're going to go somewhere now and catch some pigeons. Maybe go down the Albert Dock. I'll take you where we used to go, down the Albert Dock. So we're nearly here now, we're in Sefton Park. We're going to go and grab some pigeons. Well, hopefully we're going to grab some pigeons, but yeah, when me and me mate Paddy, we're on the way to grab pigeons.
Fuck.
When me and Paddy are on the way to grab pigeons, we repeat, you're going in the box. Because we get a box and we just fill the box up with pigeons. You're going in the box. That's what I say to the pigeons. I whisper to them. After I've caught them, I get them and by the head and I grab them and I whisper to them, you're going in the box. You never know what else. Yeah, there's some, yeah. Wood pigeons. Oh, you can eat them. Oh, can't see no birds here, can you?
I can't see through your windscreen.
I can't see fuck all. I think it's...
What was you saying, Jazz? Yes, you were. Will you take the piss out of Mr. Simon Jordan there?
Who?
You?
Who? Oh, yeah, there we go. Ah, Simon, I'll see you later. Where are you going, you? This is going to be embarrassing.
Who for?
For YouTube. No, well, I don't care. But here's the thing. Everywhere you go, right, it's got a different way for the stray pigeon. We call them strags in Dublin, they call them gicknas. Gicknas?
Right.
Write in the comment, hey, come here, we'll catch you. So in it's a crow. So in Dublin, so write down in the comments where you're from, what's a strag pigeon, a stray pigeon called? We call them strags. Look at this. There we go.
And there we go. There you go.
What I'll do, I'll get them.
Huh?
What I'll do now, I'll get them behind that bush there and then jump on them there. You've really never seen this, have you? How do you think?
I've seen that.
Oh, look at that there.
It's like a scene at Home Alone. You remember that?
Yeah, in the Christmas park. The pigeon lady. Well, what we used to do, right?
I want to see you run after these now. This is the funniest thing.
So look. Have a look at the legs on them. If any of them got rings on. See, that's a little bit spooked because you're here.
Nothing to
do. You don't like wolves. Look, I could be a little bit rusty here because I haven't caught a pigeon since I was... Wow, fuck, that's always going to land me then.
You said you wanted a dog.
Come on, mate. My mate's got a plan mix here. Wait till I catch your dog.
Yeah. Once you are not a bird.
What is your love, Kenny Blue?
No, he's a labradoodle. Huh? Come on, you. Stop it. It's very cheeky,
Kenny Blue.
You'd think we didn't feed him.
Have a nice day, though.
You too.
Well, that went tits up.
That's all. Really, really wanted to be on YouTube.
They're there, though, that.
So have a little look at the legs on them. Some of them got rings on.
Zoom into Pigeon's legs now.
See, before there was none ready, and now there's loads.
I just want to see you catch one.
Gotta get the thrust first. Now I spooked him, I'm covered in mud. You know me game, they're onto me. I'm being bumbled. I feel like a knobhead now. This time, I won't miss.
I think the dog running through your pigeons has ruined the day. So you're admitting defeat.
I can't believe that. I can't believe that, you know. What has happened, right? What happens?
Show us your hands, Jazz.
Yeah. You take a turn to peace, so you would say, I'm first, grab Bagsy. What was Bagsy to use?
Yeah, Bagsy is Bagsy first.
Bagsy, yeah.
Yeah.
Or Dibs.
Dibs, same
Dibs?
Thing, yeah.
Bagsy, Dibs. First. You wouldn't say Dibs, like Bagsy. Bagsy, first, grab.
Yeah, Dibs.
What would other people say for that?
Yeah, same thing.
Dibs,
Bagsy.
Write in the comment section below. And also, like, what do Scottish people call pigeons and grab?
Dinner.
Yeah, yeah. So, Scottish people, we call pigeons mix. What would you call them?
Pigeon.
Just a pigeon?
Yeah.
Yeah, we call them mix.
Or a bird.
Yeah.
But you call your bird, your bird.
Yeah, your bird. Wonder why it's your bird?
I don't know.
Mean? Is that a scouting?
Maybe.
Is that just a scouting thing, your bird?
But then in general it's that. Look at those birds over there.
As in pigeons or women?
As in women.
This is where we used to come to catch pigeons. It's different years ago though, we weren't as busy, it's like a bit of a tourist attraction now, but it was just a little bit tough when we were kids. We'll come down here and catch the pigeons.
Actually catch them, you mean?
Yeah, well, yeah.
No, I've got to be honest, that was a piss poor attempt.
Oh, what it was, don't you? The grass.
You can't blame the grass.
Glass is that wet glass snow in the winter? That's a winter wet glass. Like, it's like ice in it, really. You just slip on your tongue catching pigeons.
Absolute cobblers.
I was going to just... I would have caught that if it was on concrete. Everyone knows, everyone's seen it, so... They can back me up on that.
Seriously.
See that there? That's where we're going to go. That was the rice factory. We used to call it the silo.
Alright.
And it wasn't... This was just gravel. I remember sneaking out with my mate coming here. Me and Martin. Martin took me down here. Martin was a year older than me. I must have been 10.
Where are you going?
I was racing the silo there. I must have been 10. And Martin was my idol at the time. Martin was a schoolboy champion. And Martin took me down here to race the silo to catch pigeons. We came down here with a loaf. Can't see no pigeons, can you, anywhere?
You are?
See if you like. Can't see no pigeons anywhere, can we?
Well, you couldn't catch them if you... Oh, God, that's hit me head. Look. Just look.
Catching us.
Still too slow.
Oh, we are, look.
No way.
Seagulls are rootless, you know, they bully the pigeons. Take all the breath.
So what's that, what's that building behind you?
That was the rice silo. That's the... The old rice silo, obviously it's abandoned now. It was abandoned in the 90s, but this would have been not far from where the old customs house was, and the building was a customs house that got bombed in the war. I think it was abandoned for like 20 years. But what they done, they knocked it down. Instead of rebuilding it, it was a listed building, but they knocked it down and just built a car park there for 20 years.
Look what you've just done. Right, Jazza.
There we go.
What you?
Yeah.
Are you going to go seagull catching? This I would pay to see.
This is getting worse now, isn't it? Here's one. Seagulls. Here's one. Look. The bully the pigeons.
Ah, you've been done. Seriously, the looks you're getting right now.
I want to see me on a Saturday night when I'm covered in blood in front of thousands of people. I think I look bad now. You want to see me then? I think the key to life is not giving a fuck. I think that I really worked on that, you know. You know what? I used to think, oh, what's he think? And now I just give him bollocks. I call it staying on me mat. So when you go in yoga, you get a bit self-conscious and all that, am I doing it right and all that? And he heard one time, just stay on your mat and don't worry about no one else. So now, when I'm just looking like a scruffy bastard trying to catch me dinner, I just call it staying on my mat. Oh, then meet your man there. I don't think that did it. The rice silo has got pigeons in there anymore. I feel like it has, but I also feel like it hasn't. By the way, there is none.
You don't like the rain?
I can't believe we're here doing this again. Oh, here we go, look.
This is like, the pigeon man used to go over there, and when we couldn't catch the pigeon ourselves, if it had a ring on it, we used to say to the pigeon man, Jesus, mate, get us that, because we'll look after it. And he loved the birds, you know what I mean? So we knew that we'd look after it. But there was one pigeon, it was in 1997 with a yellow ring, checkered pied, and it used to always come back here, so no one could tame it. You get it and put it in your loft, but no one could tame it, you know what I mean?
We kept it for a month. We let it out and it came back here. And it was so spooked because it had been caught so many times. You just knew what you were up to. So it wouldn't come near you when you were feeding it.
You're not even funny.
How did you end up? You just fell over and ended up on your head with your feet in the air. You see the red one over there?
Yeah. No way.
You didn't believe it, did you? So? Ah, look at that one there. It's feet have been collared, so you put your fingers around it. And hold it like that. Look, this was struggling really bad, but... Look how bad that is. Like a young Mike Tyson. But look, you see the feathers. You have a lot of lice. So we'll let this one go, because it's got no ring on it. And we won't chop its leg off. Have a look for the ones with the rings on. You all right there? You were upside down, you know. Look at that jet ski there. A lot going on today here, isn't it? My ADHD is off the charts.
Just for the record, that's what I fell over because of walking backwards.
Did that just get in your way?
I was walking backwards and basically didn't see that and ended up on my arse.
How did you end up with two legs in the air?
Because I was doing that and then I'd obviously tripped and went.
It fell in stages, slow motion. On this one, you ready? What's this dive? Oh. Nearly, come here, lad. Next time, see what happened there. Don't see the way the floor was dead slippy. Ha ha. Don't say that's the same fella.
No, it's not the same fella.
Come on, get a little bit of a rush. No one need to go and go for it. Feathers there.
He's not hungry, funnily enough.
No, I think he's a bit terrified, isn't he? Have you heard the story about my Tyson?
Go on, tell me.
Pigeons. He had a pigeon lot, but my Tyson was a week catching pigeons like this himself when he was a kid. Someone broke into his pigeon lot and pulled the heads off. Get the head and twist them off and pop the head. And you can throw them in the air and they'll still fly.
Hey.
Allegedly. So, Tyson said he had his first fight, he snapped on the kid. Red Buchan was a kid. So he snapped on the kid at his first fight because someone had done that to his pigeons. But not going to defend himself, but he meant that much to him, he defended him, you know. Right, go on, that's it, you've had enough now, go on. Oh, go home. Go on, that's it.
I'm not going to argue with you.
What a sad little man I am. Go on, Pigeon, grabbing on my own. You wouldn't think I've got three kids, would you? Right, go on, oh, go home now, go on. Done well, Annie. Vinco boxing.
Please welcome first into the arena and to the red corner, Dario Rosa.
Good evening, I'm delighted to be joined by Jazza Dickens. Jazza, big fan of yours, mate. Every time you're fighting, I'm always rooting for you, mate. How are you? How are you keeping?
I'm good, I appreciate that. But all about playing hands tonight. He's got a good set in the bill. Hamilton always been on the road. He has got the best of him, but he will show the best of him.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this battle has been sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control. Black camo and yellow shorts from Liverpool, presenting Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after six rounds of action, we go to our scoring referee scorecard, Stephen Gray. He scores the bout 60-54 for your winner, from Liverpool, Dexter Guerrero-Macazar.